Hello, fifth grade. So over the last couple of weeks, you guys have been doing really good at discovering volume and figuring out the volume of rectangular prisms are. You guys were tested yesterday and Wednesday over how to find the volume of regular rectangular prisms and irregular rectangular prisms. So first, let's take a look at this one. This was on your second mid-mod assessment yesterday. You guys were tasked with finding the volume by using the formula length times width times height. And you guys were asked in your first part question, what is the length? I know the length is that front-facing wall, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 cubes long. I know my width is how far back something goes, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I know my height is the how tall something is. I was about to say the height of something. It's how tall something is. That's an awful age. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So on your mid-mod, you should have gotten the length of 6, the width is 5, and the height is 6. And now let's multiply to find that overall volume or how much space this rectangular prism takes up. 6 times 5 is 30. When I multiply by 6 again, I'm going to get 180 cubic centimeters. Now, you guys did a really good job setting up your equation, solving for volume. On this particular instance, there was another answer that was 108. You guys typically chose this answer as opposed to 180. Double check your work. Just because it has a 1 and an 8 and a 0 in it doesn't mean that these are the same value, obviously. So please be careful with multiple choice and double check. It's 180 because when I multiply out, I get 1 in the 100 spot, an 8 in the 10 spot. And a 0 in the 1 spot. Very different from this value.